Would you look at the size of this human being? 7 feet tall, 355 pounds.
Look at him! Go for it!
The following contest is a triple threat Extreme Rules match and is for the Classic Alliance Championship. Making his way to the ring from Lagos, Nigeria, weighing in at 355 pounds, Commander Azeez.
Whether with Apollo Crews or on his own, he has shown that he is always a dominating presence.
Yeah, amazing power, surprising agility. Commander Azeez has all the tools to hold court over the entire WWE.
Indeed, the largest superstar in the history of sports entertainment.
And his opponents, first, from Grenoble, France, weighing in at 520 pounds, the eighth wonder of the world, Andree the Giant.
There is only one Andree the Giant.
Yeah, a man whose supremacy is unmatched, and a man who helped build the very foundation of WWE.
A tower of a man, but the epitome of evil and destruction.
Andree can do whatever he wants, whenever he wants.
And from South Carolina, weighing in at 382 pounds, Big Sean.
So much on the line here tonight, guys, as we look to crown a new champion.
That's right, Cole. We're guaranteed to have a new champion at the end of this one. It's not very often you can say that.
Neo, he seems to have a great deal of respect for the sports entertainment industry, both past and present.
That truly is an important component to success, Michael. If you can gain an understanding of what those who came before you did to be successful, then you're sure to be successful yourself.
Fully confident challenger in their corner, absolutely hell-bent on capturing the title. So extreme rules are now in effect in this one. Anything goes from here on out.
That's right, Cole.
If these superstars can dream it, they are absolutely free to do it. There's nothing standing in the way of their most ambitious and sadistic imaginings.
Oh, vicious headbutt.
Just malicious.
That's disrespectful.
That's just disrespect right there. I kind of like it. Running STO plants him.
Nicely done.
The Giant is leaving no breathing room here.
Andre's being a dominant force.
Paint a picture for me, Corey. Hypothetically, what are some tactics you'd use to win a no DQ match?
I'd stash some kendo sticks beforehand, maybe have a buddy waiting to give me a much-needed hand, maybe throw a Saxton like a fastball special. That's the beauty of a no disqualification match. You can do all that and not get dinged. The sky is the limit.
Absolutely no telling what's underneath the ring tonight.
As a couple of Hall of Famers once said, it's time to get the tables.
He's feeling the effects of that last hit.
Holy, meet the barricade.
To the outside.
This could get wild. Folding chairs, but they can also fold you in half.
Taking things to another level, bringing out the ladder like this.
And gets tossed back into the mat. Bang!
And I can't tell where it's originating from, but Azeez is dripping blood now.
There's the pin title on the line!
He is still very much in this.
Big four. In the line of danger now.
Oh no, look out, guys! Broken in half!
It just went crashing through the table!
If this were a table match, Saxon, I'd say Mazel Tov. Instead, I'll just say my condolences.
He comes off the attack. Any one of these attacks could cause irreparable damage, but I don't think you can come back from this many.
Up and
getting back.